Haven't found the true root cause of your chronic symptoms? Maybe you have seen dozens of doctors and been through tons of protocols, but you're still battling with chronic symptoms. Today, we're going to give you three root causes of chronic symptoms that nobody has told you, so be sure to stick to the end. I'm Brooklyn Hannah.
And I'm Nick Hannah, and we are Christian brain rewiring coaches helping you reverse your chronic symptoms. If you like what you hear, subscribe to our channel, hit the bell to be notified when we post a new video every Tuesday. So it's common for people with chronic symptoms to go to a conventional doctor's office and have them tell you it's, you know, anxiety or stress. Then from others, you may find out that it's actually toxicities like mold, heavy metals, EMF, or it's the infections like Lyme, Candida, or parasites. So what is it really? I mean, from a brain retraining perspective, we're going to tell you our thoughts here today. So let's start with number one. The first of three possible root causes is perceived trauma or stress. So, yep, the first doctor may not have been too far off. But hold up, what do I mean by this? This can be an event, any event in the past that caused significant mental or physical distress. Examples could be, of big traumas could be things like car accidents, abuse physically or mentally, losing a loved one, having to go to war, alcohol or drug addiction. Or it could be even smaller traumas and stressors like obsessing over diets and food, fear of EMF, chemicals, mold, a heightened fight with a loved one, or social trauma leading to isolation.
The thing is that it's not always necessarily the things that happened to you that caused the trauma or stress in your brain, but the way you perceived them. What do I mean by this? Well, two people can have the same thing happen to them, right? So let's just say each were bullied. One person could shake it off like it's no big deal, and this person just moves on with their life. The other person sees it as a big threat, a big stressor, is angry towards them, creates a negative thinking pattern, thinking, if that person treated me like this, then everyone else must be this way. And maybe they avoid social situations or hate thinking about when they went to high school. This is the person who has created a perceived trauma. So this same thing can happen with anything in the past or a current stressor, actually. So we currently work with many people whose brains have been traumatized not only by people, but like diets, EMF, chemicals, mold, their illness, their symptoms, and more. So how your brain perceives trauma is a main root cause, which leads us into number two. So number two is fear. So many people with chronic symptoms have perceived past and current traumas or stressors, and once this happens, they then can begin to develop a ton of fear. They find out that certain foods or EMF is bad, then they avoid those things. We know that avoidance behaviors lead to fear. Then, whenever they eat the foods or around the EMF or mold or whatever it is, their brain instantly starts responding with symptoms and negative thinking patterns predicting their symptoms. They go into trauma loops, which then causes them to go into the fight, flight, or freeze response, leading to symptoms. People may also start fearing a current or past trial or stressor. Maybe you start reliving being abused in your past, or something your husband did to you, or even something someone said to you. This is a fear-based response, and typically people with chronic symptoms fear their own symptoms of illness. Now, this gets people even in a deeper hole. So they do everything to try to control their symptoms in the world, and it just leads to more fear and more symptoms. Look, I'm telling you all this not to call you out, but to give you hope. Healing chronic symptoms does not have to be complicated. Brain retraining can completely reverse all this fear, negative thinking, and trauma. Calming the stress response and balancing the limbic system is the answer.
Last but certainly not least, number three, disconnection from God. Now hold up, before you blow up the comments and get mad or anything, hear us out. I'm not saying that all of you who are sick don't have a relationship with God. Clearly not saying that. But God can allow, of course, trials in your life at any time. However, I do believe one of the main root causes of chronic symptoms is fear. So yes, disconnection from God by not walking in faith is playing a part here, right?
Yeah. So for me, I know that sin and negative thinking patterns had a ton to do with it. Like I mentioned, I had like eating disorders, exercise addiction, alcohol abuse, you name it, all in my past, which was rooted in sin and my choices. So sin, such as abusing alcohol, drugs, sex, whatever it is, all messes with your mind tremendously. Our choices come from our thinking patterns.
Yeah, and to bounce off of that too, I was in fear-based mode too, because in going through this with her, not the fear of not knowing the future, will she get better? all the different things of my past came in. So yes, it's a trauma loop, and it can get bad if you let it. So disconnection from God and fear.
Yeah, definitely. So when I have been caught in those trauma loops and fear, I didn't feel close to God, and I was living based off my feelings, and it can get you into a lot of trouble.
Yeah, living based off your feelings, not good. Yeah. We all know that. And again, as we know too, fear and faith are opposites. God says, do not fear, as you all know, over 300 times in the Bible. God does not give it a spirit, give us a spirit of fear, but of love and power and of a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1:7 says that. So again, it goes without saying, but walking with God will certainly help you.
The good news, healing from chronic symptoms does not have to be that complicated. It does not always require loads of detox protocols, restricted diets, and strict avoidance. These symptoms are usually a result of the fight, flight, or freeze response, we believe, that starts in your brain and can be calmed with brain retraining. Now, if you want to learn more about the fight, flight, or freeze response, we'll place a card above of a past video that we did about this. So we believe this fight, flight, or freeze response is a result of the traumas, the stressors, the fear, and the disconnection from God. So do you want help with this? Join our free Facebook group called Brain Rewiring for Health and Happiness. The link is below. Also, if you're interested in working with us in our program where people are showing up every single week with a list of wins and getting their life back, then fill out the form below and we will reach out to you. God bless.
And Godspeed.